Yeah, I guess I was here. So, hey, what's up? This is my neighbor. He's really ugly. Can't you tell? He'll be in my next video. I swear to God.
I'm not used to this.
Oh, anyway. Okay, his name is Jeremy, and he'll be in my next video. I promise. Right? Please thumbs up and comment if you want him to be in my next video. Good evening, YouTubers. It's Wendell again from the island of Guam. Now, today's video is another versus challenge. This time, it is Elaine Duran versus Chloe Redondo. And they will both be singing Almost Is Never Enough. Now, I didn't know either of these two singers until I stumbled upon them throughout my YouTube searches and suggested videos, and all I can say is, wow! They're both amazing singers. Whew! Now, just like last time, in my other video, when it was Johnny Manuel versus Dalton Harris, I'm not gonna show you the whole video of them singing the whole song, Almost Is Never Enough, back to back, okay? I'm just gonna show highlights so that you can hear them side by side. And then afterwards, I'm going to tell you who I think did it best. So here goes.
Try to deny it as much as we want, but in time, our feelings will show up. Cause sooner or later, we wonder why we gave up. The truth is, everyone knows. Almost is never enough. So close that you wanted me the way you wanted your babe, then maybe we wouldn't be two worlds apart.
As we want, but in time our feelings will show. Cause sooner or later we'll wonder why we gave up. The truth is, everyone knows how almost is never enough. So
wow, okay, wasn't that incredible? So just to summarize my four categories from last time, I will be using the same four categories. Number one is excitement value and performance. Number two is pitch and technical singing. Number three is emotional connection to the audience and to the song. And number four is star power. And if there's a tie, I'm going to break it with number five, personal preference, okay? So let's start with number one, excitement value. For me, they're both exciting in different ways. Elaine Duran's riffs and runs are smooth, cool, and refreshing. And she is, wow. First of all, as a person who records themselves, has been recording themselves their whole life, ever since I was a little kid, anything they can find, cassette player, whatever. She's only using her phone and in her house, apparently. And she sounds incredible. I can't tell you how hard that is to just sound like that just using your telephone, your cell phone. And Chloe Redondo is obviously in a studio and, you know, it's been processed already, so it's pitch perfect anyway. But, and she did a whistle tone. That was really exciting. And she's young, she's got the braces, and everyone loves youth, right? So they're both exciting in different ways. So for this one, I can't decide, it's tied. Okay, number two, pitch and technical singing. Now, this one is not really fair because one is process and one is just on cell phone live. But I went and looked for recordings of Chloe Redondo live, and she's really good too. But I would have to give this category for me, Elaine Duran. I think her riffs and runs are more complex and she does them perfectly. It's so easy to be out of tune when you're doing just even one note off when you're doing a complicated run, but she's absolutely nothing wrong. She's incredible. Okay, number three is emotional connection to the song and to the audience. Whew. Okay, I'm going to give this one also to Elaine Duran. I think this song is just more appropriate for her and it sounds more believable. I think she's older, right? And it just sounds like she has more life experience to draw upon with the content of this song. Chloe Redondo seems a little bit young to be singing this song, although, I mean, I'm sure she's young enough. She's probably experienced love or this sort of situation, but I just feel like it's more genuine hearing it from Elaine Duran. Okay, number four is star power. And I'm going to give this one to Chloe Redondo. To me, she has sort of this teen pop star look. She looks very likable. Not that Elaine doesn't, but like between the two, I have to choose. I'm going to have to choose Chloe Redondo being more of a, you know, pop personality type person. Okay, someone that you can follow like on Instagram and lots of things. I can see little girls really wanting to maybe be her. Okay, so that's my opinion. So after the four categories, we've got Elaine Duran 3 and Chloe Redondo 2. So no tiebreaker needed. If I had to do a tiebreaker, I'd also prefer Elaine Duran. So she would probably win 4-2, but the winner here is Elaine Duran. Okay, so that's it for today's video. Let me know what you think about this versus battle. Who did it best, Elaine Duran or Chloe Redondo? I'd like to hear all your comments below. And don't forget to like and subscribe and share my channel if you like the content that I'm creating. Until next time, bye-bye, take care, stay safe, mwah, mwah, mwah.